is one of the new shades. I love this so much. There went the box. Hey guys, welcome back. So got another haul for y'all today. So this is going to be kind of like a makeup-y slash birthday haul. So I've been picking up some makeup here and there, and especially kind of like around my birthday. This was kind of like some of my birthday presents from Timothy. And then I have some other things for my family. So I'll do the makeup stuff first because I figure that's what you're probably most interested in. But then I have some other stuff. I have some cool handmade jewelry things that I'll show you, and just some other fun things. So this is a little kind of random hodgepodge haul. So let's get into it. So first, starting with some lipsticks. My mom is adorable and she loves HSN. She loves the makeup stuff on there. She loves like the kitchen stuff, the home stuff, like bedding and things like that. A lot of times she'll tell me when different things are on there. I'll pull it up on the app and watch it. And we'll talk about it and whatnot. So anyway, Too Faced was on there recently, so she bought me these. These are some of the La Creme color drenched lipsticks. They were on a really good sale. So she got me the color Sugar Daddy and then Topless. So these are both little, you know, side birthday gifts from my parents. This one is Sugar Daddy and then this one is Topless. So really pretty neutrals. They're just really comfortable cream lipsticks. So nice. The packaging on them is really nice too. Like the outside is so pretty and they're really like nice weighty feeling lipsticks. So super pretty. The other swatch that I have on my hand over here is one of the, I bought this for myself at Sephora. This is one of the Rainforest of the Sea from Tarte Color Splash lipsticks. And this is in Beach Babe. This, I got this for the packaging. Like, I just have to admit it because that is so pretty. I mean, it's just like so sea-like and watery looking and just beautiful. So I got the color Beach Babe and it's just a really pretty neutral kind of cool toned sort of a nude. Really pretty. I like this nude a lot and it really is a nice formula. Like it's comfortable, feels hydrating, but has enough stick to it that it doesn't like go away really quickly. So very nice formula on it. I like this a lot, but again, I really just bought it for the packaging. So these next things are all just makeup purchases that I've gotten recently. So I bought the Morphe 35R palette. I don't know why I'm showing you the outside because they all look the same on the outside. But the inside, it's just a super neutral palette, but very golden. So that's why I got it. Not that I don't have golds, but it just intrigued me. It looks pretty. I like golds. So it's like really intensely pigmented. I can do like either a get ready with me or an individual review or something on this palette. If you want to see that, let me know. This is really nice. Like it's very nice quality, blends well, wears well. I'm really enjoying it so far. Is it maybe like a must have, go out and get it right this instant? No, because I mean, it's, you know, if you like these kind of colors, you probably already have these in your collection, but really nice quality and good price. So I do really like it. I was just, I don't know, drawn into those gold colors. Like they really just like sucked me in because those are so pretty looking. During the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty, the Laura Geller blushes were on there one day, so I had to go grab a couple of them. Got there at like 8:45 and I was amazed that there were any of them left. And these were two colors that I thought about getting, so I was really excited that those were still there. These are the Baked Blush and Brightens, and I got the shade Peach Delight, and this one is Honeysuckle. So that's what the outside packaging looks like. I love these blushes. I think they're such nice quality. They just like blend effortlessly into the skin and they just look so beautiful and youthful and just gorgeous. I love these blushes. So it's awesome that they were like 50% off. And then Honeysuckle. Now I will say I swirled it all together so it doesn't look very pretty right now. But I picked a Honeysuckle that looked lighter. I opened each of them. I didn't touch them, obviously, but I was just comparing the marbling in each of them, both in the Peach Delight and also with this one. And quite a few of the Honeysuckles looked pretty dark. It had like quite a bit of brown in it. So I picked, honestly, I kind of wanted like in between. I really wanted one that had a little bit more brown than this, but a little bit less brown than most of them there. So anyway, I picked the lighter one. So mine looks lighter. And my swatch that I'm about to show you looks white. looks lighter. So anyway, that was a tangent, but just know they're gonna differ depending on what the marbling looks like. So there is Peach Delight and there is Honeysuckle. So really pretty everyday color. But again, I picked a lighter one. So mine looks more kind of glowy and like a light peachy mauve or something. Just a really light neutral. So I'm excited to wear that. This one actually looks a lot lighter than I thought. I didn't realize it was gonna swatch quite that light, but I bet I'll really like it on the cheeks. And again, I love the formula. This is kind of random, but this was on clearance at my Sephora store and I saw it in one of the bins that it was about to go out on clearance and I just love the design on it. So I got that. This is the Mara Hoffman for Sephora collection and it's kind of like a little, I don't know, squatty, cute sort of a bag. So I got that. And then I got the birthday gift. I picked the Tarte set. There's also a Caudalie set, but I picked a Tarte one. And this is so pretty. Let me show you like in the actual packaging. So there are the swatches. So you get the Tartist lip paint in birthday suit. So that's right there. Really pretty. I do like these. I got one of these in, I think, Ipsy. And I was really impressed with the formula on it. I think it's really nice, kind of shocked me. And then the blush is the Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blush in Party. So cute, it's so tiny, but this is really gonna like still last a long time. Really pretty neutral mauve-y sort of a color. Let me show you in the actual packaging. That's what it looks like. I love this. I've mentioned this before. I so wish brands would have little mini versions like this. I would totally go for those more often just because, I don't know, they fit better in your collection storage. Traveling, they're better. They're lower priced usually and they're cute. A few more things from Sephora. So I got another one of the Sephora cream lip stains and this is in number 18. And I think it's like flame red or something like that. I'll list it and link it down below for you, but I'll show you a swatch in a second. And then, but it's just a really pretty like orangey red sort of color. And then I got the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in Miss Argentina. This is one of the new shades. I love this so much. There went the box. It's so pretty. It's like a bright pinky red magenta raspberry sort of a color. So there is that. I'm obsessed with that. And then up here, that's that Sephora cream lip stain. I really do like both of these formulas. I've been really liking these lately, like kind of fallen back in love with them. As far as liquid lipsticks go, I think they're one of the better ones as far as like a traditional liquid lipstick. I think these wear really well. Also with the Sephora cream lip stains, I think that these are one of the better formulas too. So both of these, I really, really enjoy. This has a little bit better price point, but this one isn't terrible. I think these are $14 and I think these are $20. So at least they're not like $25 or $30. So anyway, and I love the packaging. Pretty, pretty. A couple of other cheek products. So I got the Benefit Dandelion Twinkle. Adorable packaging on this. So this is a really pretty highlighter. And let me show you in the container. So it's kind of like a peachy champagne sort of a shade. Really beautiful. As far as the swatch, it is right here. So it's kind of more on the subtle side, but it's still really pretty. So you see how it's kind of like a champagne-y peach sort of a color? So that is that. And then I got the Physicians Formula Butter Blush. This is one of the newer shades. This is in Vintage Rouge. I also really want to find the pink one. I haven't gone like on a super duper hunt for it, but I saw this one and I really like the formula on the others. They're just really light. So I'm glad that they came out with some more shades. This one's just a really beautiful kind of like peachy sort of a shade. And it has like a really beautiful, like subtle sheen and glow to it. Really, really gorgeous. I like that a lot. I think that's very nice. So I think they made good choices with their new ones that they came out with. They just have more color to them. So I think they're gonna work for more people, but they do have those lighter neutrals as well. If you are super fair complected, super porcelain, the first two I think you'll really like, but I think the newer two are better suited for more skin tones. And then the day that I was in Walmart hunting this down, I ended up grabbing these two. Also, these are the Maybelline Expert Wear Eyeshadows. I got these two shades, the Glow Down and then Nude Glow. I kept hearing people talk about these two specific shades, and they've been on my wish list, but I wanted to wait till I was in Target or Walmart because they're a little bit cheaper there. So here they are. That one is the gold one. That one is the Glow Down, and then the top one is Nude Glow. So just really beautiful, very metallic, really pigmented. So these are very nice. These two and the silver one that I have, I really enjoy. Haven't tried them all. I've tried kind of like a lighter pearly sort of shade that I wasn't very impressed with, but I did like the silver and I really do like these. These are very nice. I got the Anastasia Beverly Hills Aurora Glow Kit. I've really kind of fallen in love with my Moonchild Glow Kit. So when I saw this one coming out, I was really intrigued by it and just totally sucked in. Let me know if you'd want to see like a specific review on this or just include it in a Get Ready With Me or something. It's just really pretty. This one is like less icy white colors with a shift to them and more color to them. So they're more of the colors than more of that like icy sort of a tone to them, but really fun. Really pretty. So there are just a few swatch there of those. And then I also got, I was really excited about this, the Persona Identity Palette. I had heard great things about this from my friend April from Wanna Makeup. She kept talking about it, saying how much she loved it. She's used it in Get Ready With Me's and it always looks amazing on her. So it had been on my list. And when it came back in stock, I decided to get it. And it's really, really pretty. I do have these like in my crease and outer corner. I have something else on my lid, but these are beautiful. Very pigmented, really blend very, very well. So let me know if you again would want to see a review or something on this palette. I don't know. I kind of have like, I don't have quite as much time to film anymore. So I kind of have to like be selective with what I film. So let me know like what you would want to see. And I can kind of like take the group consensus. But there is that really, really, really nice. I'm super impressed with that and really excited about it. I've said really a lot. Now we're moving on to official birthday gifts. So some makeup that I got from my parents. First off, the Benefit California blush. I had seen like pictures on Instagram about this coming out and I was like totally sucked in. I love Benefit box blushes. I think they're adorable. Always love them. I do have this on today. It's really a pretty, like, I have a highlighter on with it too, but it's just a really pretty, kind of like bright orangey, peachy sort of a color. It did have an overspray, like a golden overspray, but that's pretty much gone away. It does have a very strong scent. Like, I really did smell it very strongly when I was applying it to my cheeks. So if you're sensitive to scents, you may not like this blush. I think it's a nice scent, but it is very strong. I would say stronger than my other ones I have from them. Yeah, it's like a very perfumey kind of a smell. It's not a bad smell, it's just strong. So that's just an FYI. Also got this, the IT Cosmetics Superhero 4-in-1 Eye Transforming Super Shadow and Liner Brush. My parents got me this and this. This was a set from QVC, because they're on QVC. And I did use both of these today. I like these. This brush is really cool. Like it's like the four brushes in one. So this little part, it's dirty because I used it, but it like clicks up and down. So based on like where it is, it does like different things. And then it has the liner brush. I used that today too. Very nice, soft, blends well, really does deposit the shadow nicely. So I like that brush a lot. And then this palette is really cool looking. I've wanted this ever since it first came out just because it's really neat packaging to it. Like it's just kind of a funky, different sort of a shape. And it looked nice. Like I have heard mixed reviews about this palette. Seems like some people really like it and then some people weren't super impressed with it. Something I did notice when I used it today, there's really not any good mid-tone blending shade. So that's why I had to bring in the Persona palette. So that's kind of a bummer about it. There are nice shades for deepening up your outer corner, but not like blending shades. So I wish that that were in there. But I do have this gold on my lid and I use it with MAC Fix Plus. So here's what I'm thinking about this palette. I think that this is a really good palette for people who don't want to look like they're super made up. Like you just want to look like an enhanced version of yourself, but you don't want to look like you're wearing tons of makeup because the shadows are pigmented just on initial app, you know, first impressions. They are pigmented, but they're not like whoop-bam, like Makeup Geek foiled eyeshadows or anything like that. It's not that intensity unless you add MAC Fix Plus. So if you are more of like a makeup obsessed person, you're gonna wanna bring in some kind of a mixing medium, I would think, with these shadows. But I'm excited to have this. I wanna play with it more. I'm definitely going to. I enjoyed using it today. It's just, again, personal preference. What are you looking for? Now we're gonna move on to non-makeup favorites. So my sister and brother-in-law went on a trip recently and they were near a Piggly Wiggly. We used to have Piggly Wigglies in Texas, and so I have lots of memories of being in Piggly Wigglies, and we don't have them anymore. So I was so excited that they had one there, so they brought me back a mug, which is adorable. I just love this. And then a t-shirt. This is probably gonna make my camera go bananas, but it's got the logo on it, and I just like, I think it's so cute. So it just brings back good memories, and I thought that was such a sweet, adorable gift. So some Piggly Wiggly goodies. Then they got me a new pair of Sperry's. I had asked for a new pair because I love the ones I have now, but they are torn up. I've had them so long, they're embarrassing. So they got me a new pair. I really like these too because they're kind of the more like camel-y colored ones, and they go up higher. Mine that I have now go down lower and are kind of like more of a light creamy sort of a shade. These have more of that like camel-y tone to them. So I really like these a lot. I wear a size 6 in these and I think they're just super comfortable. These are the Firefish Core Linen / Oat. And again, I wear them in a size 6 and they are just super comfortable. Really cute with, you know, flare jeans, bootcut jeans, skinny jeans, crop jeans, whatever. They're just comfortable and nice shoes. And then my parents got me a pair of Vans. I had asked for a pair of Vans. I thought these were just like so cute and kind of rockery. What style are these? These are the, it says Style 23V two-tone leather gunmetal. And I wear these in a 6 and they're like a black leather and then they've got the gunmetal up here. So, and then they've got the like little Velcro-y, you know, dealies to them. So I think they're really, really cute. I think they'll look fun with like, you know, really edgy accessories and black jeans or regular jeans. Again, just comfortable and easy shoes. Like I mentioned, my mom is adorable and loves her HSN. She loves Joy Mangano and everything she comes out with, she gets so excited about. So she got me some towels. These are supposed to be like really high absorbency towels. So she got me this set, which is aqua, and then she also got me another set that's kind of like a buttercream yellow. They are really soft, very nice feeling. Comes with 2 bath towels, 2 washcloths, 2 hand towels, 2 shower towels, 2 hand mitts, and 1 bath mat. So very nice set. She got me actually 3 blankets, which just cracks me up. And I say she, these are from my dad too, but my mom is actually the one watching HSN and picking this stuff out. But she got me 3 blankets and I was like, 3 blankets, mom? You are cracking me up. And she goes, they were on mega clearance. You wanna know how much they were? I'm like, yeah, I love a good clearance sale. They were $8, at least these, this one, and she got me 1 other color. I don't know about this bigger one that I'm gonna show you in a second, but she said these were $8. So these are by Soft & Cozy, and this is the Glimmer Soft Throw. So she got me this color, which is kind of like a silvery gray, and then also kind of like a light blue, like a dusty blue color that's really pretty. These are super soft. I lifted the lid off and like was feeling them. They are really soft, very cozy feeling. So if you're needing some new blankets, HSN might be the place to check. And then this one, she already washed these for me too, which is so sweet. She washes them and then puts them back in the packaging. I have the sweetest parents ever. I'm so thankful for my family. Just, I thank God every day for them. So anyway, that's a side tangent. I'm gonna get emotional if I keep talking about it. But this is the Soft & Cozy company. This is the King California King blanket, and it's like a really pretty kind of light green color, like a light sage green. It's so soft. So yeah, if you like are looking for, you know, bedding, blankety sort of things, maybe check HSN. And then for the last things that I had to show you, I brought you in a little bit closer so that you can see these a little bit better. So if you follow me on Snapchat or Instagram, or I'm sure I've said it on my channel too, I love craft fairs. I love arts festivals. I just love handmade things, unique things that are one of a kind, made by a person who just has like incredible talent. And I love meeting them and like hearing, you know, their story and like why they do what they do and what they love about it. I just think it's really cool. So I love handmade jewelry. So Timothy took me to an arts festival and then a craft fair for my birthday. That was like kind of part of the weekend. It was so much fun. So I got some really pretty things. First off, I got these three bracelets. These are, let me get them. These are little cuffs, and I have like child-sized wrists, so they're really like small right now, but these are by Ella Jude, E-L-L-A Jude, J-U-D-E, and they are just really cool metal looking cuffs, and you can bend them, and then they have like little leather pieces inside to make them really soft and comfortable. So he had all different kinds. He had like the basic ones that are smaller, like I think these are the quarter inch, then they had the half inch ones, all different colors. He had ones that had crosses on them, words on them. So just a lot of options. Just really nice attention to detail with the leather inside. So I love those so much. I've mentioned these before, these wrapped to wear bracelets. I wear these a lot in my videos, mainly because they don't clink around. Like I love wearing like lots of bracelets, but they jingle together when I'm filming and I find them, I'm sure they would be annoying to y'all watching. So I don't wear those a lot, but I wear these a lot because they don't make noise. These are by Wrapped to Wear. This is what their little card looks like, Wrapped to Wear. And they make the most beautiful wrap bracelets. So I got a matte black one that has little bars on it, but they have really colorful ones. They have turquoisey looking ones, and they're just really well made because I've bought wrap bracelets before, and a lot of times they'll start to twist and turn. Just, I don't know if they're not made correctly or they're made too tightly or something, but theirs don't ever do that, and they just look amazing. You can wear two of them together. They look really edgy and cool. They're just beautiful. So if you like wrap bracelets that like wrap around a bunch of times, they have three ones, they have five ones, definitely check theirs out because they're awesome. I got this ring. It is just a really huge, beautiful druzy ring, and I love that it's got a really big back to it. I don't like when rings are really big and then they have a really small back to them because then they tend to spin. This one actually like stays put on my finger, and it was adjustable, so I have small fingers too. So I was able to actually wear this one and it fit me. So really pretty. She does have a website. Her booth was like really heavily discounted, which was amazing, but she does have a website with some really beautiful pieces. I'll, you know, link all these people for you. And then Gemelli, I love Gemelli jewelry. I got this bracelet from them, and they make the most amazing druzy necklaces. They have all different things. They have tassel-y necklaces and lots of like beaded bracelets, just really beautiful stuff, so pretty. Again, they do have a website, but they were heavily discounted at the show, so I got that. I absolutely love it. The one I got, you just saw it, it's silver with like a white druzy with the silver on the side. It's so pretty, it's so bright and fun. Lastly, this girl's booth was at the arts festival, and oh my goodness, she is so talented. She had so many cool things. Her whole booth just looked really neat. She had just old boxes and trunks and stuff and old gas cans that things were hanging from. So it just looked edgy and amazing, and I loved every part of it. So I got this bracelet from her, and she adjusted it for me so it fits me. It's got a really cool clasp that this comes together like that. I don't know if you can even see that, but it comes together. She said this is based off of a really old type of a chain that they found, like 6 inches of it, and they had a guy start to create this chain for them, so it's like really unique to them. And then I got this necklace from her. It's got a really cool clasp there, and it almost looks like the metal is like, I don't know, oxidized or burned somehow to make it have that cool like purpley pink blue shift to it. And then I got this other one with a key on it. Amazing, really pretty for layering. Just the attention to detail of like the different kinds of chain. Oh, I loved it. Her booth was so amazing. Let me know if you'd want me to do like a whole video about some of my favorite handmade jewelry pieces, because it's definitely a passion of mine and I love talking about just really talented artists. A lot of them, you don't see as much of it on their website, but at least you get to see some of it. And I'm sure that they could like custom make some things for you. You know, I'm sure everybody's different, but I bet some of them would. So let me know if you'd want to see that video. All right, guys, so that wraps up this random makeup slash birthday haul. So hope that you really enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Let me know down below what you think about any of these products or things. I would love to know your thoughts and opinions. Ask me any questions that you have. I'm happy to answer those. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.